In this segment, we will derive the trapezoidal rule of integration. Trapezoidal rule is one of the basic ways of finding the approximate value of an integral. So let's suppose somebody tells you that, hey, I want you to find the value of an integral which is of this particular form. That the function or the integrand is given to you, which is this, so we call this as the integrand. That's the lower limit of integration. And this here is called the upper limit of integration. So someone is asking you to calculate the value of the integral of the function f of x, which is the integrand from a to b. So if we want to find it approximately, one of the things which we can do is, so let's go and look at it graphically. So let's suppose if I have a function like this. And somebody says, hey, I want you to integrate from a to b. So this is my function f of x as a function of x. And says, hey, this is b, let's suppose. So you have the value of the function here, you have the value of the function here. Actually, the area under the curve is all the area which is from A to B under this curve here. But in trapezoidal rule, what you are basically doing is you are drawing a straight line. You're drawing a straight line from the value of the function at A here to the value of the function at B here. So basically, these coordinates here, the coordinate there is A, comma, F of A. And the coordinate here is b, comma, f sub b. So what you're trying to do is you're trying to find the area in the curve. So the area under the curve of this straight line would be this area of the trapezoid, because this shape which you're seeing here is basically that of a trapezoid. And the reason why you are doing this, somebody might say, hey, why are you trying to draw a straight line going from point A to point B, is when we talk about numerical integration, the reason why we are approximating our original function by this particular straight line, let's suppose, is mainly because we know how to integrate under a straight line, because a straight line is a first order polynomial. And from your integral calculus class, you already know how to integrate under a straight line or under a linear polynomial function. So that's what the bottom line is about doing numerical integration, that you're approximating the function, the original function, which you may or may not be able to find exactly, by some other function of which you know how to find the integral. So let's go and derive what trapezoidal rule is. So basically we have to find out what this area under the curve is, under this curve going from point A to point B. So since this is a trapezoid, I can just write it as the area of a trapezoid. So what is the definition or what is the formula for the area of the trapezoid? It's simply the average of the length of the parallel sides. So sum of the length of parallel sides. So if you take the sum of the length of the parallel sides, you take the average of them two, which is basically means that you are dividing it by two, and you multiply it by the perpendicular distance. Between the parallel sides. So that's what you're doing. You are going to multiply it by the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides. So in this case, the parallel sides are the value of the function at A plus the value of the function at B. So those are two parallel sides. So you're going to take the length of that one side, which is F sub A, length of the other side, which is F sub B, you're going to divide it by two because that's the average. And then you multiply it by b minus a, because that's the distance between the parallel sides. So your trapezoidal rule formula is basically becoming a to b, the integral of f of x from a to b is simply approximately equal to b minus a times the value of the function at a plus the value of the function at b divided by 2. Okay. So this is the approximate formula for the trapezoidal rule. It's b minus a, which is the width of the interval, times the average value of the function at a and b. So you can also look at it this way, is that this particular term here is actually some average value of the function. It's not the exact average value of the function. This is some approximate value of f bar in a comma b. Because you're only taking 2 points from a to b, the one at a and the one at b, dividing by 2 and getting some approximate value of the average value of the function in a, b. In fact, you'll have to take infinite number of points if you want to get the exact average value of the function from a to b. In that case, that would give you the exact value of the integral. Why is that so? That the reason for that is as follows, because if you remember your integral calculus class, the average value of the function from point A to point B is given by the value of the area under the curve from point A to point B times B minus A. So in that case, the exact value of the integral can also be viewed as the exact average value of the function from point A to point B times B minus A. In this trapezoidal rule, what we are doing is we are approximating that average value of the function by the value of the function at A plus the value of the function at B divided by 2. Because in order to be able to calculate this exact average value of the function, I can also do it on a point-by-point basis like I'm doing it here, but I'll have to choose infinite number of points from point A to point B.